NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 80 in our series Create a RubyGem NerdDice. And looking at the backlog, last video, number 79, we went in and significantly refactored the convenience methods module to clear out about 100 lines of code that was similar enough but redundant. So we still got a little bit of work to do here, but the regular expressions were largely refactored out into constants. The match pattern and delegate went from probably 20 line case statement to you can see a couple of four lines. So that's where we're starting from. So the goal in this item is to see if we can account for highest and lowest and role kind of all in one method, and same thing with total and highest and lowest. At the very least, I want to see if I can get highest and lowest condensed from three methods down to two, or two methods down to one, and see what we can do there for this. So I'm going to, let's see here. So we've got get number to keep from method name, match data gets that. So we can maybe return nil here if it doesn't exist, like if there's no match. And then similar to how, like, if there is a modifier, we can go with highest, lowest, or nothing. So let's see if we can play with that. So we've got that. Take a look at our no offenses. I think that's a breaking change yet. Yeah, we're not doing anything there. So in our number to keep here, let's see. If we can do this. No. this in the regular expression. Oops. This is in JavaScript. Unmatch close parentheses line 85. Advantage or disadvantage. I need a double parentheses there. Oh, did break some stuff here. Take a look at what we broke. Broke everything. Undefined method. So we're not matching anymore. Got that working. Actually, refactor that underscore out. With that later. So that can actually be condensed down to one line now. And I guess the try it with roll and see if we can get this working. So the D has to have dice after it, and then you could have thank you. get this condensed down. It's a number to keep. Parse number to keep with our dice. Define this method. So we'll refactor that out later. Either be, we'll do advantage there. So if we have match data, return dice dot highest, otherwise dice dot lowest. Broke some stuff here. Let's take a look. NerdDice received roll dice with unexpected arguments. So we've got that situation with the default. errors there. So how many failures did we get? Situation. So I think we just need to account for that, which we can put in that method instead of passing it a default now. Get number of dice from method name. I think we can just do this with an if, else, if, else. So if match data, this would be this specific situation is etc. Alright, so let's take a look at this. So we're looking for D plus, and then this part of the still breaking stuff here. 8 failures. Now it's the NDNN situation. Look at that specific set of failures. So It's all the role. No, some of it's role DNN, some of it's role NDNN. There are 8 of them. Let's look at this closely. So included in total is not working on role NDNN or DNN. Included in total. It's all about the inclusion in total that maybe I've got stuff. Also want got some debugging stuff ready here. Let's all right, so we've got our one failure. It's a failure with my debugging code, not with the actual logic. All right. So, first match for the second match and get number of dice. So let's take a look at the first match here. So it's the four D. The second one would be so in this situation, second match was nil, and in line 77, or D8 with disadvantage. So we might not actually be excluding stuff yet. So we wrote the method. I'm not sure if we called it. So parse number to keep. See if that number to keep in parse number to keep. Parse number to keep is coming in get number to keep from method name. See where that gives us. Number of dice. It's giving us 4. Oh, this is, I think, the cause here. So, unless match data. And then, if number of dice is actually 1, we do not. Let's get rid of that. And then, since we're calling this everywhere now, So I think I've got it. The issue is that the now this is being called every time. So yeah, we're still failing. Wrong number of arguments. All right. That's fine. We'll just do that also with total for now. So in roll. Still need number of dice. All right, back to failing. This video is running a bit long, so I'm going to stop here and we'll pick up in the next video. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.